Hello riders from around the world. I guess that many of you were waiting this review from a long time. So do I. I have today this beautiful Kawasaki Versys 615 model 2018. How good or how bad is this machine? We're gonna find out in the next few minutes. Stay with me. Let's start with the ergonomics. So I am, as you already know, a little above 6 foot or 185, and I weigh about 100 kilograms, which is 200 pounds roughly. So as you can see, the seat position, it's low. It is actually 84 centimeters, if I'm not mistaken. And the riding position at the moment for me, for a guy with my size, it's not bad actually. I can improve it a little bit, but it's okay. What I don't like and what you have to consider is the position of foot pegs. So when I have my foot on the pegs, I really need to have this almost like a straight angle here. So in the long run, this could be a little bit tireful, but it's fine, it's okay. And suspension, in my opinion, it's soft, but there is some kind of adjustments here. So maybe it could be improved. It has upside down forks, 41 millimeters, and the brake discs on the front are 300 millimeters. On the back is a single disc 250. The engine is a 650cc parallel twin, and it has 69 horsepower, which is more than enough for this type of motorcycle, if you ask me. One of the downsides, at least for me, it's the 17-inch front wheel, and it's come with these alu wheels, which are really easy to bend if you go off the road. But as I said, this is a minus for me, but it could be a bonus for you. If you ride only on the streets, this is a perfect solution. Let's walk around now and talk about building quality. Looks like from Kawasaki did a really nice job. I really love these colors, poisoning green or whatever they want to name it. Everything is well designed, all details are very nice, clean and smooth. I like the final surface of the paint. It's some kind of reflect on the light, and it's really beautiful. So you can see that the rear fork is adjustable. You can do it from here. And the foot pegs are the standard street bike pegs. There is some kind of plastic cover here, which is, I don't know for what, maybe more for optical purpose than some kind of protection. So as you can see, the exhaust pipes are really exposed, and you will really need some kind of engine guard if you want to travel with this motorcycle. It's the same with the radiator. You definitely need to do something. Nissin brake calibers. The brakes are actually very good. I already tested. And the front face is a typical Kawasaki shape. The windshield is adjustable. I'm gonna lift it to the high position. And we're gonna try test it later on the highway, but I think this is the highest position. Okay, anyway, it's difficult with one hand. What more? The tail is light. It has only just one column, not the typical fat tail, which is good. And yes, passenger handles are really nice. The seat, nice cover. Two levels. We already discussed these two levels, but for short riders, definitely a positive. Let's check the dashboard. Nice, typical tourist handlebar, 22 millimeters, a little high. Location of the mirrors are nice, good visibility, good design. The standard instrument, kill switch, start button, throttle, hazard light, indicators, horn, everything what we normally got. So here we go from here. I can show you that there is some kind of adjustments on the forks, and they can be manipulated a bit. But have a look now, this gap here. I don't know what you are able to see because of the dark, but it has such a big gap here. Look at this, I can put my arm all completely, so a lot of wasted space here. So for what is this? I don't know. And also when I sit on this motorcycle, I have the impression because of this low forks and the position of the forks is so low, I have the impression that I'm in sport bike and I need to really bend my body this way to ride it, but actually the position is very straight because of the handlebar. Okay, let's go to the tools actually. Let's put on the ignition. As you can see, analog clock on the top with RPMs and the most necessary stuff on the bottom. Speed, clock on the right. Oh, sorry, so this is the mileage, the clock is on the left. Gear counter, the petrol gauge right on the bottom, light for the neutral and indicators. Very, very simple. Actually, it's a little bit different than the Kawasaki versus 1000. Let's start the engine. The stock exhaust is hidden here underneath. Actually, a really nice design. Really well designed and planned. Okay. The sound is not bad actually. I like it, it's nice. You can see where the shock is positionated. It's a typical Kawasaki design, a little bit on the side. I don't know what are the positives and negatives of this type of shocks. Okay, let's go to right now. Once again, riding position. It's okay. Not exactly for me, but it's okay. The wet weight of this motorcycle was 215 kilograms. So this is what I read from the specification sheet. It's fully loaded with 21 liters of petrol. So the tank is 21 liters, which is very good. And the consumption supposed to be between 4 and 5 liters per 100 kilometers. So you should be able to ride almost 400 kilometers before you need to refill your tank. First impressions of the brakes, of course, very, very good. This is the way it should be. It's a brand new motorcycle. The clutch is very smooth, easy to operate. Once you start riding, it's feel like a very light motorcycle, and it is really easy to ride it. I think it's a perfect for beginners because of the size and because of the weight. Yes, I can confirm that the brakes are very good. So the gear shifter is on good position. It's very accurate. So we have a traffic jam as usual. And as usual, I'll try to cheat. And as usual, many people will comment after that this is not allowed in Germany and I shouldn't do it, and if I don't have time I shouldn't test the bike or so on and so on. So guys, I am not a German and I never say that I am a perfect rider and obey all rules. And as you all know, when you have a motorcycle, sometimes you need to ride like me to split the lanes or whatever in the traffic. So I think this is a good opportunity for me to show you how easy or how difficult it is to do it with this type of motorcycle. So I do it with two purposes. First, because I want to get out of here, I don't want to stay on the sun too long now. considering that today is 35 degrees and I'm dressed with all of my gear. And the second reason is just to show you how the bike is capable to move in the traffic. So for those guys who really want to judge me about my riding style, please don't do it, because I am not an instructor. I never said that I'm a perfect rider. I'm just a simple guy like you, like many of you. So, as you can see, it is not really easy to filter in the traffic. It's not because of the bike. There is nothing wrong with the bike. It's because there is not enough space. So I have to wait a little bit longer. At least if someone move and give me a chance to do it a little bit more properly, like this guy here now. Okay. Okay, because the bike is not so low and the position of the mirrors is high, it's allowed me to go between the cars without touching the mirrors. But if you have a sport bike, it's not going to be possible. Okay, thank you. So as you can see, some people even move and leave me a bit more space. But some are just ignore me, or maybe not see me. I cannot blame them, especially in Germany. But anyway, I've got some progress, and maybe finally I'll be able to get out of here. So definitely the bike is fine for filtering. Okay, so I passed the cars, now I cannot because of these guys. Okay, anyway, no problem, I'm almost there. Okay, so finally we've got it. Thank you, man. Okay, from here I'll be able to take the next highway, which is fine, and test how it performs on the highway. Because as we discussed, guys, this is not a typical adventure machine or off-road machine or whatever. This is a travel bike, and if you have it, you will probably spend a lot of miles on the highway. That's why it's good to check what it is able to provide here. Really nice power. Let's see now. 120, 130 kilometers per hour with 6000 RPMs. With 6500 RPMs. Considering that the number of the clock, the maximum number of the clock is 13,000, so it should be okay to ride on this RPMs. And as you already know, Kawasaki have got this a little bit more noisy engines. Not exactly noisy, but they usually work on high RPMs, so it should be okay to have a cruising speed about 120, 30, 40 for a long period. So from the engine point of view, from the power point of view, it's great. It provides more than I will ever need. I'll say just me, because everybody is different. Some people will never buy a bike under 150 horsepower. Some will be happy with 26. So everybody is different. For me, this bike got more than enough power, more than enough. Okay, we'll go back on the highway, right into the city on the way back, I'm gonna test how is with the vibrations. So far I don't think that it has, but just to pay more attention on the highway again. Busy day, hot day, everybody is on rush, normal. What I'm gonna check now first is the flexibility of the engine. So as you can see now, I ride with 80 kilometers per hour on 6th gear, and I will twist the throttle. Okay, it pulls well, but it is really noticeable. You have this noise underneath telling you that there is not enough power, but anyway, in some stage you just get it. It's fine. Windscreen, it's very good. Some buffeting here on my shoulders, but this is normal, so it is good. To confirm once again, the brakes are excellent, or at least from my point of view. Let me show you this gap once again, guys. Look at this. Look at how big this gap it is. You can store a lot of stuff here. Or at least I will do it if this bike is mine. Some spare parts or whatever. For city ride, excellent. Commuting, excellent. For long trips, I think will be great. As long as you stay on the road. So far so good. I cannot say anything bad about this motorcycle. Very easy to do maneuvers because of the size and the weight of this bike. Okay guys, my conclusion. This is a perfect city bike, perfect for commuting, filtering in the traffic, right around the city, make a tours. I'm guessing they've got possibilities to have a luggage here. I think these holes here are for hard cases, the stock hard cases. The performance is more than excellent. Everything is good. The design is beautiful. The windscreen work well. The only con I found, for me of course, it's the front wheel, 17 inch, and this position, the position of the bike, it's orientated up to the front wheel, so this will be really tricky to ride it off-road. But it is obvious that it's not an off-road motorcycle, so it will be perfect for beginners, people who just started now, or with someone who want to travel
cheap because this bike is going to be very, very economical. And the price at the moment exactly, I'm going to write it in the video when I find it out. Many people ask me every time when I test motorcycles to tell you my opinion, is the motorcycle or the certain motorcycle good to go on the trip, like my trip to Mongolia. So guys, in Mongolia you can go with any bike. You can go even with sport Yamaha R1, no doubt. The problem over there will be when you hit unpaved roads or when you need to go off-road. But every year they work on it. So if you go this year or maybe next year, there will be brand new roads around Mongolia. So the question is supposed to be more concentrated, like is it possible with this bike to go off-road? Yeah, it is, but you have to keep in mind that it has all wheels and 17-inch front, so it will be very difficult to ride it in some sections, and also will be very easy to damage it in many sections, if you understand what I mean. Most of the roads in Mongolia were smooth and nice dirt roads, like in your backyards or around your forests, but there were a lot of sections with really, really bumpy roads. It looks fine, but it's really, really bumpy and with a lot of lines digged from the melting snow. So when you ride it, actually it's constantly bumping like this, dun, 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 dun. And I don't know how much this type of rules will survive on this type of terrains. So this is what I think about it. It's a really nice motorcycle. If you want to ask me, is it my type of motorcycle? Definitely not, because as you know already my preferences and the type of the trips I would like to have. So I told you many times, but I'm gonna tell you again, the weight is always matter, and I prefer to have a motorcycle which is able to go to the hardest part of my trips. So if I have planet 15,000 kilometers trip, and from this 15,000 I have 2,000 kilometers off-road, I'll prefer to have a motorcycle capable to go well on this 2,000 instead of have motorcycle like this, which will be great on the road but terrible on the dirt. I prefer the opposite way, because with an off-road orientated bike you can do it just fine on the road, but you cannot do it the opposite way. So that's everything I think, guys. Thank you very much for watching. And on Friday Saturday morning, on the 9th of June, I'm going to my trip to Ireland, Scotland and UK. So anytime I have this possibility, I will post videos from the spot and will try to keep you updated. Thank you very much for the whole support from everybody who sent me the details and everybody who invite me in their houses, and the PayPal support, and for everything, guys. You're just great. It was my pleasure to serve you and to make these videos for you. As usual, thank you very much for watching and see you next time. Ciao.